In this video, I'm going to share with you something new that Kittl just came out with, and it is called Image Sets. And it's AI, and it helps you create the same consistent design style throughout. So I'm going to use this with my Corgi right here. We're also going to try other things. I think this is great if you want to do some image design packs, if you want to sell packs of things that look exactly the same, or if you want to be consistent on your designs and t-shirts or other products, this will be great for that too. I'm going to show you exactly how to use it and where to find it on Kittl. So let's go to Kittl right now and test it out. So here we are on Kittl. I wanted to show you first, before we go into the image sets, I wanted to show you where you can find the latest things for Kittl. And you go to learn and blog, and you'll notice it's right here. So if you want to learn more about how to generate this, you can come in here, read all of this. I'm not going to go through all of this right now. I'm just going to get right into it and show you how to use it. You can always come back here and use it later. And I'm going to go back to Kittl and show you how to use it. So first things first is we're going to start a new project. So right here, new project. And then I'm going to pick my pod presets, t-shirts. I'm going to hit create. Now you can pick whichever one you want. You may not want to do t-shirts. You might want to do something else. And that's totally fine. So I'm going to zoom out here. I'm holding down option with my scroll wheel, which is really nice in Kittl. I love that they do that. And I'm gonna go over here to Kittl AI. Now they've added so many things to AI. Check this out with AI. They have the image generator, which you know, sets generator. They're coming up with this design generator, which is gonna be good. It's in beta. I'm not gonna show you that. I'm gonna do the sets generator in this video. When that's out of beta and new, I'm gonna show you that as well. But here, sets generator. So the only way to do it right now is to upload something, a design of yours that you want to have in the same style. So you can see, so I can save up to 12 styles. I think it depends on the subscription that you have. The higher subscriptions would have more and the lower would have less, I guess. But I have 12, so you can put in different ones here. I'm gonna drag in a copy of this Corgi that I have right here. So not drag in, but I'm upload. So I'm gonna upload, I named it Corgi, perfect. And it's doing that. And I took away the background and the circle and everything. I didn't want it to get confused. So you'll see what it looks like. Just a regular Corgi right here without the circle, without the colors, without the Japanese text. I didn't want to confuse it too much because I just want the design. I don't want all the other things. Now, if you wanted all the other things and the circle and the thing, you could put that in. But let's try this out for now. Okay, so that's a Corgi. I'm going to do a cat. I like a dragon, that's cool, a dragon. A panda, that's always fun. And we can put up a bunch here. I'm gonna just do 4, and then I'll do a koala right there. Okay, so the idea behind this is that a cat, a dragon, a panda, and a koala will be in this same art style. Now, this is not their art style, it's copying my art style, which is really cool. Let's see what happens. It's gonna do a set of 4 here, and hopefully it matches. So I'll pull up what it looks like. I'll drag in my Corgi here actually, just so you can see. And then I tried it out with some other ones, but here's the cat. Here's the koala. Here's the panda. And here's the dragon. Yeah, oh, I hit dragon twice. Now look at that. It kind of copied my style. I'll zoom in, it's pretty crazy. The color is the same, the white outline in the middle of the face with the eyes closed, exactly the same. Maybe it could be a little thicker, but I mean, not bad. It's not eating a ramen, it knew to take that away, but it kind of used this design on the bowl, the pattern, to make some of those designs on the cat. So maybe I should have said eating a ramen and it probably would have got it closer. But yeah, pretty cool, right? All the same kind of style. Now this could be kind of a graphics pack, or maybe you want to do one, make a design for each one. I wonder if it would do it eating ramen. So let's go back to his sets, and then I'm gonna say a cat eating ramen, a dragon eating ramen. I don't know if it's this advanced, I hope I'm not breaking it. Eating ramen, And a koala eating ramen. All right, let's try this. All right, let's move these away. Delete those and let's see how, wow, not bad. There's a dragon eating ramen and a panda eating ramen. All right, not bad. I really like this bowl too. It kind of did the bowl the right size, so pretty cool. Okay, so that's mine. It's a little difficult because it's a very complex. I would actually do it with simpler stuff. So let's go. I'm going to try something even more different. I'm going to go into Kittl AI, actually go into images and Kittl AI, and let me try a style that's already here. So one of the things you could do is, and then what I want to do is take a style from here and then try it out. So I'm going to do a vector first because I love using vectors. And let's see. I think this is good. I'm gravitating towards the corgis here. Okay, so this one right here. Remember, we can only upload it. So I'm going to take a screenshot of this. Boom. And then we'll go back into Image AI, Kittl AI, back to the sets generator. I'm going to upload this design that we just took a screenshot of, and let's see if we can do it. I'm going to use the same thing, except I'm not going to say eating ramen. I'll just do a cat, a dragon, a panda, and a koala. All right, let's see how good it goes here. I'm going to use all my credits, but it's okay, we're testing this out. Okay, so this one is what I'm looking for, is kind of a black and white design style here. Yeah, not bad. Look at that. Pretty similar. I would have liked more black on this panda because this panda looks kind of sad, and this koala too. So the color needs to be a little better on these two, but I think these two guys right here are a lot stronger, right? Cool. All right. Let's see what it does with something a little more complex. I'm going to do the same thing, Kittl AI. I'm going to go back into images, do the Kittl AI images. This time we're going to do clip art. Let's do something. I don't know. I'm already doing all this cutesy one. Let's do something more. Yeah, this one right here. This one seems... right? That seems tough to do. Okay, we're gonna really test it. I'm gonna do a screenshot of this here. And let's see if it does it. So this is kind of a bear making a face. So let's see, we go back to Kittl AI, sets generator, bear making a face, last screenshot here. A cat, a dragon, a panda, a koala, maybe a bulldog instead of koala. All right, let's try it, see what it does. See if it can imitate the same. So this one has kind of splotches in the back, which is cool. And yeah, cat, not bad. Dragon, really like it. I wish the cat was cut like this, where it's just the floating head and not the background, but I could fix that. This was a panda. Kind of neat. Again, I wish it was the floating head, but the colors and everything really matched. And there, the bulldog. Wow, what a cool design style. So there you go, that's how you use it. I would use it for different things. Oh, one more. Let's do coloring book style. Let's go back to images. Oh, these kind of images, yeah, would be really cool. But I was thinking coloring book ones where you just draw in the shape. I wonder if you can just do like simple like this, because I think this would be really cool to do like different coloring book images, and that would be all the same style for it. So let's try that. Command shift 4 and then drag it like that for a screenshot. Boom. All right. Go back, last one. So many different ways that you can use this. You can make a graphics pack, you could use it for t-shirts, you could make it for coloring books. I think this is very versatile. very helpful. Okay, so I got the line art here. A cat, a dragon, a panda, a bulldog. Let's just do, yeah, panda would be good. Dragon, yeah, let's leave that. Okay, here we go. And the thing I like about this is it doesn't take that long either. This is real time that we're doing it. Yeah, this is good. See that? These are just like this, where it's a coloring book image, and you can use this. Maybe the dragon's too detailed, but this one, perfect. This one's pretty good too for coloring books. So yeah, not bad. Oh, I know a good one. If you have posters, if you wanna do the posters in the same size. Okay, so let's do that. So I'm back here on images. Maybe I wanna do posters that look similar. All right, this one, I found this one. It was just the second one. It's kind of an interesting style, and maybe I would want a poster like this. So I'm gonna do Command-Shift-4 again and just copy the middle part of it like that. And then we're gonna go back into Kittl AI, get rid of this here and upload this last style. So I'm gonna try and do different cities and see what happens. So let's see, because it's a city, I'm gonna say New York cityscape, LA, or Los Angeles cityscape. Let's see, Miami cityscape. What's another big one? Chicago. Well, let's do like international. Let's do Tokyo cityscape. All right, I'm kind of interested how this would be, because another use case for this would be maybe I want to do a bunch of posters that they're all the same style and we're selling it on my store, right? So let's see this. Again, really fast. Look at that. Boom, 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 boom. Yes. Look at that. Same style, different city. Now you can't tell it's New York or Chicago or whatever unless you, at least I can't tell. But it definitely has the same style, but with different buildings and different sunsets and different things. And so all of these could be like a poster set, right? And you can put them all together. So really cool like that. Lots of different ways to do this. I think this is a cool idea on how to create the same consistent style throughout your AI, because that's one of the complaints with AI is that, oh, I got one that I really like, I wanna make another one like it, but now it's not gonna look like it, especially if you're doing like books or illustration books or things like that that needs to have the same style, or in this case, you know, different posters and stuff. So if you can think of something that you want the same consistent style throughout, this is what this is used for. So there you go, that was the new image sets from Kittl. So many use cases for it, I had so much fun playing with it. If you wanna play with it, go to Kittl right now. If you don't have Kittl, I have a link, a promo code in the description for 25% off any of the plans, the pro plan or the expert plan if you wanna sign up and if you're not signed up already. And if you wanna learn how to use Kittl for design, I have this video right here that I did recently where I made a quick design using Kittl. You can figure out how to use it and get some sales this Q4 with some t-shirt designs. So thanks again for watching. And as always, guys, keep creating and keep learning. I'll see you on the next one.